Oggi 8 agosto siamo qua al Post Festa. Abbiamo l'onore di intervistare una grandissima band folk metal, nonché dei miei grandissimi amici. Questi sono gli Idle Folk. Bene, iniziamo subito l'intervista. So, let's start our talk with the brand new album Velua. I mean, this album was released via Napalm Records and it celebrates the Velua. What do you think this album mean to your fans and to Idle Folk?
Exciting journey. It's a journey we take over through our history and the place where we come from. On the other hand, it's also a light subject. After some heavy shit went on in the band, you know, and now we have a light subject where we can dream away and get our attention elsewhere and just see the beautiful things just around us after whatever crappy things happen to you, you know?
Well, I think let me explain the situation over here. It's really loud noises. It's a stage with Comfort playing on it, and they're doing a good job. But let's focus on the interview. I'm sorry. So, Velua is like you said. It's something lighter than you know the whole Batavian Wars against the Roman Empire. But it's also something that's really ours. You know. We all come from around Arnhem, and we all grew up with the stories about Velua, with the cruel stories, also the fun stories about the folklore of Velua. And we said, well, we put some of the lyrics of Strijdlust is Geboren, the first album. We had some lyrics about Velua, like Valaouwe, which means Velua, basically. But then we said, well, why not write a whole album about it? Because, you know, it's where we can rest. It's where our heart lies. So we started writing an album, and we said, well, let's make it a concept. And we came up with so many lyrics about it that we said, okay, this is going to be it. This is going to be our next album. And we dubbed the Velua, and we wrote a lot of stories about the Velua. And that's basically it.
The best thing about it is that we actually had to just say, okay, here we stop, because there are too many stories.
Yeah, right, so many stories. I mean, from a songwriting point of view, what's the difference between Batavi and Velua?
It's quite a big difference, because ever since Uit Oude Grond, we felt, you know, we loved Uit Oude Grond, but during the recording process, we thought it could be better, you know. The songs are not finished. With Batavi, we did an approach that worked out. We worked out more of the songs. We did a better approach. And then with Velua, we said, okay, we're not going to record the songs unless they're finished. And their the singing is finished. The everything that's on it is finished. So we created the whole song. We wrote it. We rewrote it. We made pre-productions. And until everyone was very happy with the songs, we were like, okay, this is it. So I think we just took a lot of time for the songs. We put a lot of care in it. And that's what makes Velua different than other.
Actually, you say the typical songwriting.
What?
Actually, the most weird songwriting part was probably Batavi for us. So, because we had a concept and a story, and there we created everything towards that. And over here, it was more like we were used to, actually.
Okay, thanks. Now let's talk about Idle Folk's live performances. Okay, your CD release party that you usually keep in Arnhem, the so-called Strafskaai van Kittenfest. Okay.
And you're saying that the right way, man. That's fucking awesome for an Italian.
Okay, that's alright. I mean, that show went great, and the rest of the shows also went great. Why do you think Hydropox fans are so loyal to you?
I could say it's because of our big charm, because Joost and me are still in it. No. But I won't say that.
Yeah. That's it. No, actually, I guess it is. It doesn't matter what we bring. Everybody can be rest assured that what we bring is quality. And that's something we only create something that we would buy as a fan ourselves. So I guess that's one part. So it doesn't matter what we bring out. If it's a t-shirt, you know you can wear it for a long time. If we create a CD, you know, it will take you to somewhere, tell you a story. And next to that, we have something typical, you know. Something we cherish. We really want to make it a Heidelberg product. So I guess, of course, here and there you let somebody down, but in general, everybody can agree that it is a typical product. It is something new every time as well. So it's a new horizon. It's a new story, maybe from your back garden, and it's quality.
Okay, let's now talk about Pagan Fest America 2013. I mean, that was your most ambitious tour. You went to the United States, okay, and now you have friends from all around the globe. How did you find that experience in the United States?
It was so weird, actually. We really didn't know what to expect, you know. There were a lot of people on our Facebook that said, come to America, come to America. But, you know, only those guys, they couldn't fill a room, you know. But then we went to America, and there were so many people who just loved us. And it was crazy. It was like Bushfest every evening. And we were there. We said, oh man, this is going so great, so we had to create a song about it, obviously, Finland.
One of the weirdest things for us was that even people booked like hotels and flights for 5 shows in a row and traveled all the distance, and they said, well, this is the first time in over 10 years that we can see you. We never expected to have people that dedicated over there, and it was for us an eye opener. Like, this transcends beyond us or me or him or us as persons. We created something that people can relate to and do on a daily basis or on a weekly basis. And we influence people's lives with that, and to see that you do that so far away from your own bed, you know, it's really hard to comprehend. We're really down to earth guys, you know, and each time we're just amazed, like, how the fuck did we ever get that reaction, or did we deserve it? What the fuck? It is like, yeah.
I mean,
it's deeply rewarding.
Deeply rewarding. I mean, but now, can you explain me why every Heidelberg fan can sing in Dutch?
Sorry, what?
Can you explain me how every Heidelberg fan learned to sing in Dutch?
That's not true.
Well, yeah. It's a thing that we sing in Dutch, and they want to learn where our lyrics are about. So we refuse to sing in English, and fans will instead learn Dutch. But, you know, you did a great job at learning Dutch, And there are also a lot of fans around there, around the world, who are singing in Dutch right now. We went to Mexico, and I think there were about 500 people just singing at Gelders Volkslied. Phonetically, of course. But it was fucking awesome. You know, it's always good to have new experiences, you know. Singing in Dutch is not the thing you do every evening. So I guess with Heidelberg you can do this at the same evening. So, yeah.
It's 0.6, right?
Yeah.
Sorry, it's our second.
Okay.
First show was in Padova together with these guys.
Yeah.
It was 2006 in Padova, and I know a lot of you people were there because there were about 200 people and they were absolutely fucking crazy. So that was our first experience in Italia, and we loved it.
Next thing, one of the weirdest things is we had our first Prosecco in 2006 in Padova, and since then we drink the shit every show.
Question, how do you find Foskfest 2015, and how did you find Foskfest 2011? Can you make a comparison? Is it still the same great? I mean,
I would say Foskfest 2011 was there were less bands, I know that. There were also a lot of people, and we really enjoyed it. And you know, I hope for the same thing today. We just walked around, and we could talk to so many people. We could talk. We could drink with so many people, and we could just have fun. You know, and I think it has to prove. But today, I think we're going to have the same thing. So hopefully it will be as good as 2011.
I just brought in an extra guy.
Are you enjoying yourself on this edition of Foskfest?
Oh yes, I'm enjoying myself very much here. Absolutely. We had a fantastic show. The audience here is great. I'm having a time of my life. Absolutely.
And we found Heidelberg's performance awesome. I mean...
oh, here they swarm in. Come on. Big hug, baby.
Hey.
What are we doing?
We are launching.
Lounging. Yeah. I like lounging.
Not lounging.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Not lounging.
Are you ready for the launch?
I mean, Lars, are you enjoying yourself here?
Yeah, I am. Now that the sun is away and we have a little bit of Dutch weather here, it's great. I really like the temperature right now, and I like my hair getting wet. Yeah, it's really great.
Heidelberg cast and crew over here.
Okay. Abbiamo anche l'ultimo membro degli Heidelberg, Cruz.
So, a guitar check?
Yes, sir. That's me.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Absolutely. Yeah, it's nice. Really nice. Dutch weather.
Is it the first time you play in Italy?
No, I played in Italy a bunch of times, but the first time with Heidelberg.
He's got a famous band called Detonation. Wait, thank you Andrea, thank you for a great interview.
Cheers. Thank you for having us.
Bene, gli altri poveri ringraziano, alla prossima.